talk about terminal diseases, we are referring to a number of conditions that an individual will have and for which you know that progressively, if care is not taken, progressively they lead to death. Some of them will be chronic renal failure, HIV, immunosuppressive conditions, and so on and so forth. To this type of patients who may have these terminal diseases, one thing that is common within them is their immune system, which may be compromised. And to this effect, I think that the group that should observe enhanced infection prevention and control methods. And that goes for even everybody, like keeping the environment clean, keeping their hands clean, washing their hands under running water, staying away, most importantly, from these infections that they are susceptible to, by keeping the social distance order that has come, by staying at home at lockdown times, and also by eating well and doing everything that will keep the immune system active to combat any type of infection that they may contract.
I would say that it's still not easy for those of us with chronic kidney problems and then other ailments relating to that kind of disease. It's really a difficult time, and I would say that people who support us, it's really difficult to get money. And then as a result, most of us are really struggling to pay for dialysis and then even for medications. Unfortunately, a lot of the people are dying. Most of the time we come for dialysis and then the people we meet, you hear they are no more, like they are no more, they are dead and gone, or because they are not getting the monies to come for dialysis, which is very unfortunate. And then almost every week we are recording people who are dying, not just because of the disease, but there are a lot of them who are dying because they can't afford the dialysis. Even the thought of it alone is really depressing. And we, myself and another patient who are now still struggling and surviving, we are making a passionate appeal to the president that this kind of gesture that he did a few days ago, if we can be considered, so that at least maybe by the time we come for dialysis again next week or something, or in the coming month, we will hear that the cost of dialysis across the renal centers has been reduced drastically. Over here, we are paying about, we pay 230 for per session, which is not an easy thing. And you need to come for dialysis three times a week. It's not an easy thing. So we are appealing to the president if something can be done so that the cost of dialysis can come down for us, so that at least for the time being that we've not had transplants, we can still be coming for dialysis.
Well, no, as a hospital, we do not have an opportunity to know who has COVID-19 or otherwise. And as directed by the President, the Minister for Health, we are supposed to screen every individual who comes into the hospital for a possible COVID-19 infection. To this effect, we have had to limit the access, entry access to the hospital, where we ensure that as long as you come to the hospital, whether you're a patient, a relative, a vendor, or whatever, you go through the infection prevention protocol. That one will ensure that you have available running water with soap to wash your hands, you have a clean towel to clean your hands, you have a nurse at the triage area who will check your temperature and ask certain questions about your travel history, whether you have a cough, whether somebody in your house is coughing. And if you are cleared of all this, then you go to the mainstream service for attention. If you are positive for any of this questioning or interrogation, you are directed to a desk we have created that we have named Cough Desk. That will take you through further interrogation. And then if you fit the case definition for testing for COVID-19, a rapid response team that is in place will quickly be notified, and then appropriate attire and with the appropriate method will take your sample for further analysis in Noguchi. At this point, then we'll hold you in the holding bay that has been created. If you do not have any serious condition that will require any serious medical attention, we have a holding bay for you. You are observed till the results come back from Noguchi. So for all those that we have that have come back negative. But also, if you have any comorbidity, like diabetes, like asthmatic attack, and so on and so forth, we also have another holding area that have the necessary gadgets that even as we suspect COVID-19, you are also treated for the condition for which you came to the hospital.
You know, Ghana have been preparing for this since the president gave the necessary directive for all of us to follow. We have, on behalf and on the part of management, provided from internal resources the enhanced IPC materials that are required to protect staff, the patients, and then their relatives as they come around. There are a number of measures too that we have put in place to ensure that we reduce to the very minimum the risk of infection to this staff. Recently, we commissioned the production of alcohol-based hand sanitizers within the institution that we are also supporting other facilities with in this time that they are in short supply. Government has provided us with quite a good number of PPEs, and last week, the military track made a presentation from the medical stores on behalf of the Ministry of Health that came to augment. You know, this is an ongoing process, and the usage of PPE is very, very, very high. Any suspected case that you have to treat on the ward require a new set of PPEs. And in a day, every patient who comes in with a suspected COVID-19 and also has any comorbidity will have to be treated. And therefore, our consumption for PPEs are very high. As we continue to fight, help augment the resources that are already available.
All right. So.